Rick and Morty, Season 6, Episode 6, Jurassic Mort. If you couldn't tell by the name, is another Jurassic Park kind of episode. The first Rick and Morty Jurassic Park episode we got was Anatomy Park. That was all the way back in Season 1. So if you're a fan of Jurassic Park parodies, you'll probably be a fan of this episode. All in all, out of the gate, it was a pretty good episode. I can't say that I loved it as much as episode 5 or episode 4, but all in all, it was pretty good. It was a solid episode, probably 3.5 out of 5. I can't say that it was great. I don't want to say I don't think it was meant to be great, because I assume when you create a show, every episode is meant to be great. But this episode really felt like it was meant to just lay the foundation of what the second half of the season is going to be like. Because there's only going to be 10 episodes this season, so we're already in the second half. So moving forward, I think they really wanted to lay the foundation of what to expect with the rest of the episodes. So how this episode goes is dinosaurs come back to Earth. And it turns out dinosaurs didn't actually go extinct, they just evolved to a point of basically having a society full of Ricks, except dinosaurs, actually past his level of intelligence. So as far as we knew, Rick was the smartest person in the entire universe, in the multiverse, really. Until, of course, we found out that he separated all the other multiverses where he wasn't the smartest person in it. And it turns out that the dinosaurs are actually seemingly smarter than Rick is. Now, I'm not 100% sure if that's true, but it seemed like it. How they improved on some of his technology, it seems like maybe they had the edge. Maybe the dinosaurs had the edge intelligence wise. So dinosaurs come back to Earth and they fix everything. They said the reason that they left is because they made it so great, they made Earth so great, that they just decided, let's go out and basically do benevolence, let's go out to these other planets and make them great as well. So they come back, because Earth is their original home, so they come back to check on those dinosaurs that they left behind. They didn't know that an asteroid had come down and killed all of them, and that humans now were in charge of the world. So they come back, they see the state of the world, and they're like, we're gonna help you guys, we're basically gonna take over, rule the world, do everything for you. You don't have to do anything, you can just sit back and relax, we're gonna take care of everything. To the point where no one's working anymore, there's no war, there's no crime, there's nothing, everyone just gets to sit back and chill. So of course people start hating it, because then they have absolutely nothing to do. Everyone in the family starts hating it, except for Jerry. Jerry's chilling. Apparently he had written a book about how to be able to chill like he does and not care that he's not doing anything. But so the president asks Rick if he can get the dinosaurs to leave. If he can either kill them or do some science thingy, whatever. He doesn't care, he just wants the dinosaurs gone so that the world can go back to being messy, but giving people's lives purpose. I talked before that this is a season about character development. This one, like last one, I can't really say was about character development. Last episode was more about relationship development between Rick and Jerry. This one was mostly just commentary that, yeah, there are things in life that suck, essentially because they suck and because you have to do the thing that sucks, it makes life feel like it has purpose. You're not just sitting there, things are happening around you, and you're just kind of wasting away. You're involved and you're engaged. But so the president asks him, get rid of these dinos. And he says, okay, for a price. And the price he asks is to host the Oscars. So he gets Morty and he's like, okay, we gotta go and find some dirt on these dinosaurs. Why are they actually trying to help us? Why are they actually being nice? It can't just be, they're just such good, I was gonna say people, just such good dinosaurs that they just wanna come and help us. So they go, they see the dinosaurs. The dinosaurs' tech is even better than Rick's at the moment. He wasn't prepared for that. They give him a portal gun that's better than the portal gun he makes, and they teleport him back home. But they give him a dino pamphlet, and the dino pamphlet is for when you're feeling bad that the dinosaurs are basically ruling and making everything better, and you feel useless, I guess, in comparison to the dinosaurs. So they use the pamphlet, and they actually go to the other planets that they so-called helped. And what they find out is on all the planets, the dinosaurs that were there also went extinct, because because a meteor came and killed them the exact same way on Earth. So the dinosaurs are holding some kind of rally to talk to, encourage, and try and help the people grow, like basically a TED Talk. They were basically having a dino TED Talk. But so after going to these planets with Morty and finding out that all the dinosaurs were extinct there too, Rick finds out that as the dinosaurs were evolving to basically be a Rick kind of society, just if Rick used all of his Rickness for the good, that at the same time, something devolved, and basically the thing that devolved was a rock, and that sentient, well not really sentient, super angry rock was just flying through space, always trying to kill them. And that's the meteor that just kept smashing into the different planets, killing the dinosaurs. So when everybody learns this, they're all upset because the dinosaurs are there, which means the meteor is going to come, target them, try and murder them. So everybody wants the dinosaurs gone, and the dinosaurs are like, look, we're not gonna stay here so that all of you can get killed by this meteor. So they leave, and they plan on getting killed by the meteor while they're on Mars. Rick's like, yeah, no, goes to Mars. He's standing there with them, and he's like, I'm gonna let the meteor kill me with you. And they're like, that's not cool, dude. You're just standing there to let yourself get killed by the meteor for selfish reasons. And he's like, yeah, okay. Well, what's the difference between me doing it and you doing it? Because we're both gonna die and it's both gonna look the same way. So ultimately, the dinosaurs destroy the meteor to keep Rick from being killed by the meteor, because he was, you know, he was gonna let himself get killed by the meteor just to prove a point. This is Rick. So the dinosaurs leave, everything goes back to normal, and it ends with Rick finally fixing the portal travel and the portal gun. And this is why I said in the beginning, this episode felt like a setup episode for the rest of the season, because Rick finally fixed the portal gun, and he literally says, all right, classic Rick and Morty portal travel nonsense and shenanigans for the rest of the season. There was a lot of references to the rift that was left open in space after last season's last episode and the first episode of this season, and the dinosaurs actually fixed it. So moving forward, this really felt like a setup for the rest of the season, that it's going to go back to more classic Rick and Morty. Now I'm sure we'll probably get at least one more episode in the same vein as the first episode, where the Rickest Rick, Evil Rick, whatever you want to call him, will be in it, and something will happen. Maybe not. Maybe they play out the rest of the season in classic Rick and Morty fashion, but we'll just have to wait and see. All in all though, I thought it was a decent episode. I'm a little interested as to what's gonna happen moving forward, because I kind of liked grounded Rick and Morty, where yeah, they were going through shenanigans, but they weren't as extravagant as when they had portal travel. Now I'm not saying I didn't like that, I obviously loved it, I watched the first 5 seasons of the show, but grounded Rick and Morty? I don't know, there was something nice about it. But we'll see what happens moving forward, because this season does feel, at least to me, a lot different than the other ones, and so far, it might be my favorite season. As far as where this episode stands in my rankings, probably my 4th favorite of the season, 3.5 out of 5, would watch again. If you like the video, leave a like, subscribe to the channel, really helps us out. Apparently 90% of you aren't subscribed, so you know, let's flip them numbers around. If you want more TooTaku content, link to the podcast is in the description box below, as well as the Discord, and we do have merch, we've been selling it for a while. Links to that are in the description box down below. Other than that, I will see all of you in the next one.